wish my family would be in those stands. But I know that they're cheering at home. I'm just so honored to race on this race course tomorrow. And I'll just give it all I got. All right. Go USA.
It was hot and overcast at Tokyo Bay as the start of the PTSU triathlon drew near. For Melissa Stockwell, the feeling was familiar. 5 years ago in Rio, she was part of an American sweep of the podium. And here in Tokyo, she began her race with a strong start in the water.
This is the race that left everybody talking about the U.S. and their paratriathlon team back in Rio. It was an American sweep with Alyssa Seely winning gold, Haley Dance going for silver, and Melissa Stockwell winning bronze. All three are back here, and all three have had different challenges they've had to overcome during this cycle and even over the last few months. But right now it is Hana Yukako of Japan out front in this swim portion. It's really hard to win this race in just the swim portion. Even if you build a lead, there's a chance you'll likely come back to the pack in the bike or the run.
Stockwell began her Paralympic career as a swimmer before turning to triathlon. In 2016, she thought Rio would be her final competition. But she came back at the age of 41. Her passion for competing and her desire to keep making an impact still burning.
I was a big gymnast when I was younger, and before every gymnastics meet, they played the national anthem, and I would imagine myself getting the perfect 10 in that American flag. And obviously the 10 never happened, but what did happen was kind of developing this passion for the flag, for the red, the white, and the blue. And I wanted to give back to a country that I just felt so fortunate to be a part of from as long as I can remember.
In 2002, Stockwell graduated from the University of Colorado and was commissioned as a second lieutenant in the United States Army. 2 years later, her life would change forever.
As a convoy commander, I was in charge of leading a whole bunch of vehicles from one point to the next, making sure everything goes as planned. April 13th, 2004 was a day that was supposed to be a pretty easy day. At this point, we've been in Iraq for 3 weeks. I had been on 11, 12 convoys. So we leave the gate, we go about 10 minutes into the ride, we go under this underpass, and there is just this, I mean, deafening boom, and it's the loudest sound I've ever heard. I started to get out. I undid my seatbelt. I looked over. I looked down and knew something wasn't right. There was a lot of blood. It was then when I started to realize it probably was a little bit more of a dire situation. That's when the pain also started. I was rushed from that scene to Baghdad emergency room, where I was kind of rushed into a life-saving surgery. I woke up from that surgery and I looked to the gentleman next to me and I said, I think something happened to my leg. And that's when he said, it's gone. You don't have it anymore. So I got to Walter Reed and I looked around and I saw soldiers that were so much worse off than I was. They had lost two limbs, three limbs, they had traumatic brain injuries, they had lost their eyesight. And I looked at myself and I thought, man, am I lucky? Like one leg, I mean, that was it. I mean, how could I complain? I made a conscious choice to accept the loss of my leg, not to mention that I had my life. 6 months after I was there, I got a prosthetic leg. It was hard. You don't just get up one day, put on a leg, and start walking.
Stockwell was the first American female soldier to lose a limb in the war in Iraq. She was awarded a Purple Heart and a Bronze Star for her service.
So once I learned to walk, I knew I got my prosthetic leg. I knew I was going to be independent, but I knew I wouldn't really be myself until I got back into some sort of athletics. I had, you know, always been considered myself an athlete. I was a gymnast. I was, you know, did athletics in high school and college and just wanted to kind of get back into it. One day, there was a sign on the wall, and it said, come learn about the U.S. Paralympics. And I remember thinking, huh, like, what's the Paralympics? And I went to this meeting, and he said, if you train hard enough, if you dedicate yourself to a sport, you can compete on the world's biggest athletic stage as somebody with a disability. Okay, I'm gonna do that. The
humans. We love to invent something groundbreaking, then reinvent that same thing. This became this, which led to,
oh yeah,
that. New tools, same work. At least until our work, well, changed. And with that change came choice. To be more flexible, connected, inclusive. The right way to work for each of us isn't tied to the old way. At least not anymore. So, what next? Let's build the workplace that works best for all of us.
The new Salesforce in Slack,
where the future works.
You could be me!
Me? Actually, you could be better than me. You could empower more girls than me.
Score more victories than me.
You could be the me I was doing I could be.
Not wrong. It's game time.
Just imagine how far you can go. Because you don't need to be amazing to start, but you need to start to be amazing.
Toyota, start your impossible.
All right, did you know I was the Mommy Slam Dunk Champion?
Really?
Yes, really, don't sound so surprised.
Let's see it.
Oh, you're ready. All right, here we go. Let's hear the crowd. So go to her, go to the cafe, come on. Mama, go.
Oh, Mama! She did it.
Again? You can't avoid gravity, but United Healthcare can help you avoid financial surprises by helping you compare costs and doctor quality ratings. United Healthcare.
Uh-huh.
Forget everything you know about sport. Tomorrow, we will get to define what sport is. And apparently, tomorrow, that means running in an arena with puppy horses
and jumping over hurdles.
I want to know what this is. It looks fun. Tomorrow, this is a sport. And you know it is.
This is the FedEx Cup Playoffs, where history will be made. And the final stop leads them to Eastlake, the Tour Championship. This is the chance to make a name and etch it in silver next to the greatest. One last chance for the PGA Tour's ultimate prize.
This is one of the craziest finishes on tour.
The Tour Championship. Next weekend on NBC.
As the triathlon reached the bike stage, Americans Alyssa Seeley and Haley Danz were at the front of the field.
Great start for Danz, who's taking advantage of her strength on the bike right now. So two Americans in medal spots right now in the women's race where the Americans swept back in 2016. Still waiting for Melissa Stockwell to come through.
Melissa Stockwell was a minute behind, well aware her toughest challenge was ahead of her, fully prepared for whatever was going to come her way.
Is getting through things that you never expect, these obstacles that come your way, but finding a way to persevere through them, having the heart to accept it, to move on. Instead of finding the things that went wrong, you find the things that went right.